In Dehradun, Granny had a large rambling bungalow on the outskirts of the town, on Old Survey Road. In the grounds were many fruit trees. If Granny was the best cook in the world, I was the boy with the best appetite. Every winter, when I came home from boarding school, I would spend about a month with Granny before going on to spend the rest of the holidays with my mother and stepfather. Granny had a gardener, Dukki, who lived in the outhouse with his son Mohan. There was Aya, an elderly maidservant, a Siamese cat with bright blue eyes, and a mongrel dog called Crazy because he ran circles round the house. Whenever Granny tried out a new recipe on me, she would wait for my comments and reactions and then make a note in one of her exercise books. Roast duck was one of Granny's specials. Uncle Ken, Granny's nephew, had lost a job as a railway guard and had come to stay with Granny. Uncle Ken couldn't stand small boys. I enjoyed helping Granny and Aya with the washing up. While we were at work, Uncle Ken would take a siesta on the veranda or switch on the radio to listen to dance music. "And how do you like your Uncle Ken?" asked Granny one day. "I wish he was someone else's uncle," I said. "He's not so bad, really. Just eccentric." "What's eccentric?" "Oh, just a little crazy." "At least Crazy runs round the house," I said. "I've never seen Uncle Ken running." But I did one day. Uncle Ken was attacked by a swarm of bees. He'd been smoking a cigar under a silk cotton tree and the fumes had disturbed the wild bees in their hive. He fled indoors and leapt into a tub of cold water. He had received a few stings and decided to remain in bed for 3 days. "I didn't know Uncle Ken could run so fast," I said later that day. "It's nature's way of compensating," said Granny. "What's compensating?" "Making up for things. Now, at least Uncle Ken knows that he can run. Isn't that wonderful?"
"It is high time you found a job."
"There are no jobs in Dehra."
"How can you tell? You've never looked for one. And anyway, you don't have to stay here forever. Your sister Emily is headmistress of a school in Lucknow. You could go to her. She said before that she was ready to put you in charge of a dormitory."
"Bah! Honestly, Aunt, you don't expect me to look after a dormitory seething with 40 or 50 demented small boys."
"What's demented?"
"It means crazy."
"So many words mean crazy. Why don't we just say crazy? We have a crazy dog. And now Uncle Ken is crazy too."
"Your uncle isn't crazy, so don't be disrespectful. He's just lazy."